this video, I'm going to show you programming. Today we are going to do a HTML giant JavaScript CSS project in our video. So let's start. So guys, this is how it actually looks, the program. This is the code we are going to do today. These all folders. So while doing the video, I will tell you about each tag and every JavaScript. So let's begin. Right guys, so this is I'm using an app called repelit.com for executing my program of HTML and JavaScript. In this you can choose your programming language and just program in it. This is the console. This is the output where the output comes from our HTML JavaScript codes. This is called the console. So HTML is like tag based programming. We use tags. Our tags have an greater than and less than symbol, and inside we have a program. So the basic tag needed for every HTML project is, this is the HTML tag. Every tag has an opening tag and an ending tag. The ending tag of HTML tag is this. So as I was telling you, this program we are using by HTML, CSS and JavaScript. So HTML. The HTML is a programming which is mostly used to make websites. So today we are going to make a website which is named after Green Basket. It's like a grocery store's basic website. And HTML is mostly, yes, it's used only for making web pages. And CSS is a styling programming. It's used for styling of web pages. To make the web page more interactive and beautiful, we use CSS. So CSS is three types. The first type is external CSS. This external CSS is like a CSS what? You link a file. Like this is an HTML file, index.html file. You link it to the style.css file. Any file you can link it, not only the style.css. You link it and you give a CSS code. You give that CSS code, then whatever link you gave to a file, that CSS code will be all even for that file. Like if I give in here bg background color is equals to something like red, and I give a link it to javascript file over here, so the background color in the JavaScript file also will change, and the index will h.html will change. That's the external CSS which you link other files for the CSS code. So the another type we have here is internal CSS. This internal CSS is an CSS codes which are used for an entire file. Like I use one code for this entire file, like bg background color is equal to, like that we use it for the entire file. The third type is inline CSS. The inline CSS acts as an attribute in a tag. So I told you about a tag. Inside the tag, after the tag, if we write anything like I'll show you an inline CSS code example. This is an H1 code, and I'm giving it an inline code. This style is equals to, and these commas are actually an inline CSS code. It is used inside a tag. This H1 is a tag. So these are used inside a tag attribute. Attribute are like, they are mostly a function which are used inside a tag is called an attribute. And element is like the content, and the main content in the tag is called the element, so attribute. So this inline CSS code acts as an attribute. I'll show you an example of code. So as I told, this h1 tag is tag which is used to print text. This h1 tag you can see over here, it is a tag which is used to print text. Like, I want to print a text called hello, welcome. So I will give this tag. Over here I will write welcome, and I will again close this tag. The close tag looks something like this. It has a dash and then h1. So if I run this code, see, I got a text called welcome. So with the inline CSS code, I can change the color of this text called welcome. So I'll show you how I'll change the color. Just like, as a style, we have to use the style at inline CSS code. Inside that, style equals to color is red. You can keep any color. I'm keeping red color. So now this welcome color will change to red. As you can see here, it's coming in red color, right? So let's start the project. And some more basic tags like HTML tag, I'll show you. And in the HTML tag, there are more two types. They are divided into. The first type is the head tag. This is the head tag, and this is the close head tag. So these both are the head tags. This is the first part, and again it is divided into body tag. This is the body tag. So there is an closing body tag also. This is the closing body tag. So this body shows us this main page of this HTML. In the head, as I told you, the starting the H1 tag. Let me tell you, this H1 tag, you can see here, there is a tag or even called H2. First I'll go with H1. I type the text and then I'm closing the H1 tag. So now when I run this code, you can see welcome. Now what if I make this H1 into H2? You'll notice that the size of the text changed. Like this, we have up to H6. The H1 is the largest text tag, and H6 is small. It is the smallest. As you can see, the welcome is so small. So that's the H6 tag. And then another tag which is used for printing is, that is the P tag. It means it's a paragraph tag. Inside this also you can write the text, like world, hello world, and you can end this P tag. So if you see, this This is the paragraph tag which we gave here. You can also use the inline CSS inside the paragraph tag too. It can be used also in the body. You can also change the background color with a CSS code, which is called just a minute, guys. So let's start making So in this project, mostly we are not going to use the head. Mostly I'll show you more about the body tag. Now inside the body tag, we have a tag called center tag. You can use it or not use it. I'm using the center tag. So this is center tag. It too has an ending. Center tag. So this is the center tag. Inside this, now we are going to make the main body over here. We are going to do today. So now in the center tag, as you can see, first we are going to make an image like a logo for our website. What if a website has a logo, like every website has a logo or to beautify it. So to add a logo type of picture in this, you have to use image tag, img tag. This is the img tag. Just a minute, you have to keep the... See guys, this is the img tag. For using this tag, there is even called as cr. Scr is equal to. So inside this, you have to write the address of your... You have to write the address of your... Where is your logo? Like, you have to first upload a file over here in the files. First upload a file. For uploading a file, you have to click this three dots. Click on upload file. Then your files will open. You have to select the picture. You have to first save the picture. I took these pictures from the Google, so you can save the pictures in the Google and again use it. I have saved this picture. Then I will click open. This picture I have selected. This is the logo. So as you can see this picture. See, you got the picture. So note down its address. It is written green basket logo dot jpg. So you have to write the address in here. What was it? It was green, no space bars. Green basket, just a minute. Green basket dot logo. Was there a... How was the address? Logo dot jpg. It is logo dot jpg. So this is the address. There's no int tag for the image tag. As you can see, there's no int tag. So I have written the link. You can... it's the address of this picture file right here. So if I click run, you can also, like, with the CSS codes, you can just a minute guys, you can also create... this is folder. With this you can create a folder. I'm just creating a folder to a folder called images. And I save it, and I just keep this file inside this folder like this. So this is now inside this folder image. For that, as I kept it inside the folder, I have to write folder's name also, the address. Images. This is the folder's name address where I gave. It's in the folder called image, and then inside that greenbasket logo.jpg. So guys, in this over here you can also change the font size, like. So yes guys, as I was telling, you can also add width of the picture, height of the picture, and the alignment of the picture. I have done it already. So this is the width of the picture, which is 100, and this is the height of the picture, and this align in middle. So now if I run this code, the height, as I kept it as 100, see this, align in the middle, height is 100, and this is height is 100. So you can see here the picture is inserted. So next in our program we are going to do is, we'll write a text called, inside the H1, I will give style also. You can see this, just a minute, I will keep the style. This is the style tag. Inside this I am going to keep style, color is equal, no, style is equals to color, which is green. I will keep the color as green over here, and close this tab, and in the middle now I am going to write the text, which is welcome to green basket. And now I want to end this one with the close H1 tag. So now if I run this code, yep, you will see something like this. So now what I want to do is, I want this logo to be at the side, and this must come up like in the previous one. You can see, if you run this code in our previous one, see here how it's there. It's something like this. So now here there's not even one tag called H1 tag. You can also use the A smaller tag to print text. This tag, and you can also set, you only not, as you can see here, this, you, what you will see is, if I now run this, the A tag is too small. I want it to be big, but I want to only use A tag. So for that, over here, what did we use in the previous one? This is the font size inline one code. So it is some, I'll show you, it's something like, it's a font size style tag, font want to keep it as pixels. What about let it be 50 pixels is there. So let's keep it 50 pixels. So now if you run this code, you'll get something like this. See, exactly what we want. So under this I want it to be a little more, one more styling one. It tells us that farm fresh groceries at this down. So here we can use our paragraph tag. Inside this you can use before this. Guys, one more tag is there, that's also for styling. Just a minute. This is the I tag. This is the I tag which is in the paragraph I'll write. Farm fresh farm fresh groceries, and I will just end this p tag and also this I tag. So why did I keep this I tag is, as you can see, just yeah, this farm fresh groceries is slantly like it's cross writing. What if I remove this I tag, what happens is the text will be straight, it won't be stylish. When I kept the I tag, the text was something like this. So now if you see, the text is now slanting. It gives a style, slanting handwriting style for the text, the I tag. So a little bit is done. Now what I want is, down of this I want some more images. So for that I am going to first keep the, you can just copy paste this image tag. You have to, there's no problem if you won't even use the align tag. I want it here. So I want to not give the green basket logo, I want it to be, first upload file. I'm uploading the file called, I want a picture of this picture, and I click open. So it comes in the file. First I have to keep it inside the images folders. So now let's see, it's, what is it, images, see, images slash, because it's in images, green basket 1.jpg, that is jpg format. So let's go to index.html, images. Whatever name address is there for your file, you have to use that. Green basket.jpg. Perfect. Now let's run this code and see. Oh no, wait. There was even one. So now it must work. Yeah. You can see this picture, but it's too small. So let's change its width and height. I want the width to be 1200 and 55, and the height must be something like 555. Now if I run this code, you can see this picture is too big now, but if you make this website full screen with this open tab in new tab, you will see it as perfect size in my website. And next I want two buttons over here, like I want two buttons down of this picture, which tells that first button will be some like order online button, and the other button will be a order online button, and the other one will be like a list of the groceries. So for doing that, as you can see in the previous code, just look at it and you can see after the picture over here, you can see button style is equals to color green. So you, this is an button tag. I'll show you. This is an button tag. Inside this tag we have, you can keep the style. So inside this button I am keeping a style. Let me just copy paste this code, full entire code, and after copy pasting this I will tell you guys. Copy pasted that one. Where is it? Yeah, this button style, you can see this is nothing but button style. This style is on CSS code. Color is equals to green. So the text inside the button, the text inside the button will be order online, as we gave over here. You can see this will be the text of the button, order as order online. And so it will be color in green, as we kept over here green. And then we have window on click is equals to window dot open. On click, that's an like an attribute which is commonly in a button. If you click the button, it will open a window called order online dot html. This window is right here. You have to just make this window like over here. I made it. Just open it. You can see orderonline.html. If you don't keep .html at the end of the file, it won't become an HTML file. It will be an ordinary file like this. But you have to keep .html to make it an HTML file to program in it. So when I click the button, then this, it will open into this window. So in this window will be open, and here as you can see, then I'll close the tag. Order online will be the text and button close. So like that, if you make if I run this code, I will get like this. I'll get an order online button right here, as you can see. I want two buttons. I want another button, so I again copy pasted that code, and just I've changed the window open to grocerylist.com .html. So now I have to make a folder which is called grocerylist.html. So let's make this folder. I was going to make it, rename it. So it was something like groceries list dot html, as you can see here. So now I have made this another html folder. See, it is become to an html folder because I kept dot html. So now when this button is clicked, it will take us to a window called order online. Inside this we have to again start programming. first after doing this index.html. So now here, now if you run this code, you will see two buttons. So you can see two buttons. One is there, order online. Oh wait, I forgot to change the name of this button over here as actually grow, to keep it as groceries. List. So I have to delete this whole thing. So now if I run this code, I will get another button called groceries list. Just a minute, I'll run this thing. It's taking time to load. Right, let's just as you can see, this is the picture. See, groceries list button, order online. So now let's add some more pictures down of order online. So then next I want to add an image. Image, so I'm using img tag for adding an image. IMG SCR alt is equals to, you don't need this all, we can delete it off. IMG SCR is equals to, I have to again download an image, so I'm going to go to upload file, and I want the second this image to go now. Open. Let me already upload the I have to click upload file. Let me now upload the all the files at a time. So next I have to upload this one. No, not this. I'll use, where is it? Yeah, this footer one. And I will use one more picture as, so these are the pictures of items in our grocery shop. We have sweet corn, rice, and we have bread. So first sweet corn, open again. Now upload file. Now I have to upload bread, open, and next upload rice. So I have uploaded. Now I have uploaded all the pictures at a time, so now I can keep one by one of them. So inside this, image SCR is equal to, you can now I want the second image, which is, maybe it could be this. Wait, first I have to keep this inside, these all images inside the images tag. The bread is done, the footer is done, the green basket one is done, all rice one, I had also uploaded that one, and also this one. So now all images are inside. So now I have to first search for that. Yeah, this one, its name is greenbasket2.jpg. So if you click on this again, you will see all them folders. So I have to now image, like now inside I have to keep a dot and a slash, and then images, and again the slash, and now I have to write green basket to dot jpg. So now if I run this code, I'll get another picture down of the buttons, as you can see this. We also want this pictures width to be, let me just copy paste that code over here, this one. Just a minute. After this, I have to give a space bar and give control V. So now the width also, what we want it as like that one, we want it 1255, and the height we want it 555. So and align middle. So run the code. So now I'm done, actually guys, I'm done with the part 1. I'm now going to explain. We were right over here, we were doing the H1 after doing this image 2 over here. This image too, you can see after doing it, I got a text called home delivery. So I kept the H1 tag and in the middle I wrote home delivery. And you can just note it down. And then after that I again used our image tag, and I have uploaded the image called footer.png over here. This one, I have uploaded it inside it, and the width, and I have set the width as 125, like the all ones, but the height will be a little less cause it's the footer. I kept the height as 450 and I aligned it as middle. So that's it guys for today's video. This is the part 1. I'll keep the video part 2 in the next episode. So see you guys. Bye. Hope stay safe, stay home, stay safe. Bye guys. See you next time.